Welcome back again, guys. So, we're still here. We're still in flashback. I'm still here. I've come down here. I didn't want to go down here. We need to go back up here. So, just a quick recap. We are this guy on screen in the brown leather jacket. We have a teleporter. There's a dude that needs a teleporter. We're going to go give him his teleporter. Then he said he will help us. Was kind of non-specific about how he's going to help us. He'll probably give us something that enables us to do something or to open a door. No doubt. That was the wrong run and jump there. There we go. Right. So, interesting thing about this game is it's very, very, I want to say flexible with its movement, is that You can run, you don't have to hold down a direction, and he'll just run in the direction that you're facing. And then if he comes up to any ledges or any, ledges, he'll jump up from. And he'll grab them and you can lift yourself up, which is really, really handy. Apart from when you don't want him to do that, and you forget, and you just let him run, and then he jumps up onto a ledge, and you're like, I didn't want to do that. Oops, come on and get that sensor. There you go. That teaches you to be flamboyant. Next time I'll just run and jump over it. Here's the guy. He wants his teleporter. There you go. Have your teleporter. Get a nice little cutscene with a bit of music. We saved his life. That's cool. How are you going to help us? ID card. You've You've left us your ID card. Wow. I wonder how useful that's going to be. I probably should just drop the whole pretense. I know exactly what this all does because I completed the game many, many times. But you may or may not. If you're interested in a flashback, there is a HD remake coming out, I believe. For Xbox and PS3, I think, and probably PC, I should think too, but I'm not positive about that. And to be honest, it looks like it might be a half-decent remake. There's a few extras in there, which obviously aren't in this. It looks like there's a bit of a sequence when you're all flying the bike, like you do in the... In the credits, not the credit sequence, the opening cutscene there. Looks like there's a section with that, and that might be fun. I mean, I don't know, I'd be interested to look at it. I'd be interested to check it out. It also looks like the combat's maybe a little bit more modernized, rather than this sort of generally pretty simple gun out, shoot someone, one bullet usually drops them. And it looks like there's grenades in it as well now. Which, I gotta admit, I'm turning my nose up a little bit at that. I'm thinking, really? Was that really necessary? But, I don't know. I'm interested to see it anyway. See if it's any good. Also, I mean, it's just one of those games, isn't it? That's what the ID card's for. It's one of those games that you play as a kid and then they do a HD remake of it and you're just kind of hoping that it's good and not terrible. And at the very least, at least it'll open up a game that I really liked in my childhood to other players and other gamers that haven't played it. And maybe wouldn't play it because the graphics are just not good enough, or it's on a system they, you know, they don't have, or can't be bothered to emulate it. You know, any number of reasons, really. Let's go down here. This is going to be tricky because I always usually end up getting shot by one of these. Sometimes. It's brilliant. Sometimes you can go down there, you can take them both out, you don't get hit. It's awesome. And sometimes, no matter what you do, somebody gets you. One of them gets you. And sometimes that happens. that's what's supposed to happen. I don't know if it's because I'm being extra quick or what, or whether maybe, I'm not sure, maybe it's because I'm in the middle of an animation so they can't hit you. I don't know. I'm sure there's a technical reason why sometimes I get that, sometimes I don't. I definitely don't think it's because of skill. Because I don't think this is really a skill-based game. I don't know. Alright, I am just going to have to take a quick break here, because I need to get a drink of water, which I probably should have done in the break, but hey, this is like my second YouTube video, so 1 second. Okay, I'm back. Now I've had a drink of water. Okay, we're there. Switch that switch, and dodge that sensor, which turns on the disintegrator, which I believe is what that's what's that called, if I can remember from my childhood. I keep on saying that. I really need to stop saying that. Let's roll back here. Nice. There we go. Oh, bloody hell. There's a stone. Look. Oh, excellent. Three of them now. Brilliant. Now, I know you can throw that stone to distract him and then shoot him, but I'm just going to drop down here and shoot him because that's easier and simpler. And it means I don't have to drop the stone and then pick it back up again. I mean, who wants to do that? Nobody. That's who. You pick up those stones and you hang on to them unless you absolutely need to get rid of them. I'm going to avoid that drip, though. It probably doesn't hurt you, because it's not that type of game. Alright, okay, I remember this bit. There's a key here which we have to pick up. Those two grey-looking things are turrets, which are disabled at the moment. But you have to go to the next screen and grab something which automatically enables them anyway, and you just have to jump past them. I saw something else then. What did I miss? Oh, okay. I forgot about this guy. Oh, okay. There we go. Draw back here. Gee. Oh, 50 credits. Okay. Yep. Okay. So we're picking up some credits. I'm beginning to regret turning the cutscenes on. In case you were wondering, when we originally picked up the holocube and it just came up saying, you picked up the holocube. So, on the Amiga, if it was a running off floppy disk, you could only, you didn't get the cutscenes. It just came up with a text saying, you recharged your shield, you picked up the holocube, etc. and so forth. If you installed it to the hard drive, and I think if you had enough memory, it would actually play the cutscenes. Put it this way, because I'm not 100% sure with that statement that I just made. 1 second. So, when I originally played the Amiga, I played a flashback on the Amiga, I just had a 600. It was actually my uncle's. I played it. It was I used to go around and visit my uncle and play a flashback on his Amiga. And a bunch of other games as well. Anyway, the point is, on the Amiga 600, I only had a megabyte of RAM and everything ran off floppy. So, when we played this, it only came up with the text. For in place of the cutscenes. Sorry, losing my train of thought. We're trying to concentrate on playing as well. yes. So you just got the text instead of the cutscenes. And next time I played it, I had a better Amiga, more RAM, and I also had a hard drive. So I installed the game to the hard drive. So it was either the extra RAM or installing it to the hard drive that basically enabled the cutscenes. And allowed me to see them for the first time. Although I think I played on the Mega Drive between those two periods, so I would have seen the cutscenes anyway. So, whoops. Okay, that's. Yep. Okay, yep. Nah, that was stupid. I was thinking about talking and not about playing. Well, that's okay. We're almost at the end anyway, and I've got plenty of shield left, so that's all good. Right. So yes, so I believe it's probably the extra RAM, you know. I don't think installing it to the hard drive would make the animations play automatically. It probably was the extra memory. But yes, on the Mega Drive or whatever, they were already there. So on the Amiga, if you had the floppy drive, and as far as I know, enough RAM, what you had to do was oops, that's too far again. Let's try that. There we go. So what you had to do was press Control and C, and it enabled the cutscenes to play. Now, of course, we're emulating this, so I don't really mind the load times for the cutscenes. I suppose if you were doing, I know, a speedrun or something on the Amiga, then you might actually, whoops, bloody chasm. You might actually want the cutscenes disabling. I've seen a couple of speedruns on the on Twitch. They're always on either the Mega Drive version or the Super NES version, and they always, obviously, they're speedrunning, so they go straight through all the there's my credits. they always go straight through all the cutscenes, which is fine. But and I suppose actually, although you could skip the cutscenes on the Amiga version, I imagine they would not want the load times of the floppy disk, even though it's emulated and not actually as slow as it may seem. It's still quicker on the consoles. Man, that was a long, laborious conversation, wasn't it? Jesus. You know, when they say playing games on YouTube, commentating and playing the game, when they say it's not easy, they're absolutely right. Right, so this is going to be the end of this video, I think, because it's the end of the level. So I think we'll continue level 2, yes, there's level 2, yeah. We'll continue level 2 in the next video. Yeah, we'll do that. So I'll see you next episode, and please like, comment, and subscribe, as always. And I'll see you next time.